wonder. As I could see in the newspaper yesterday, the least way you couldn't have been here before it was that you needed more sleep.
If you look around the world, it cannot be worse than that.
And where do they do it? We hope to be a medical professor. Or the minister of health and commerce. As if you have been ducks and nothing in open water from your northern vessel, you would, of course, hanging over the roof of the vessel and say, should we start to discuss tariffs for clothing now? And the answer will be, and if you say no, oh, I missed the book. So, this is the worst thing you can come up with when you try to weigh it. The physical effects of your trip. Because there is nothing that would give you a real excuse for not adapting according to comparative advantage. And sometimes trying to paint or make a drawing on the blackboard. For a moment I thought you had stolen all the choice you had. This looks like this is paint. Okay? The other is okay? Because the two country one. So if US is home, the rest is home. Okay? Have you seen the word map lately? Can you see last week? Or during the meeting in the okay. But that is the claim out there. What do you do? A tiny, very crowded country that used to be part of a colony of Britain. Of a very large neighbor with more than a billion inhabitants. And you start with an accent. So if you should produce clothes from them, it's not in US but in Bangladesh. There are so many that could work there since labeling comes to production. Do they have a lot of money in Bangladesh? No. Do they have access to very modern technology? Would it be a case where you should look at a public comparative advantage? It's not US, but it's Bangladesh. So if you meet somebody from Bangladesh, don't tell them that you've been to the US. They will beat you up. Okay? So it's not a fair deal to say if you want somebody to produce clothes with simple technology, where is no capital we have? The answer is, okay? Not much. So, what was it we learned from the first from the member? This week, we're going to underline that argument. Because when we conclude today's lecture, it's simply that be very careful if you want to start a new ministry. Don't be bad people. There are much better ways to do that. Okay? And then I'm saying that the thing is not developed completely. If you mention somebody like Brazil, the director of the country, will be coming that way. But before you are 40, it will change. If that is 30, then you go. Yep. Why don't you ask a civic or use this comparative advantage to reduce the cost of nothing? And you must have done the best to do so. Then some of the crimes they said. But then what about Paris and modern great Israel? I think it's a little bit different story, because we probably need more than the great people. The you've never been to Paris when you've been to Israel. Never. Also, really, so what we can see, some of these stories might be produced in text, but they are different. It's also been the case, so if you want to do something that has to do with code, whether in Milan, or in Paris, or in London, I think, make it a question. Now we have seen the developed culture. The developed simply means they have already an industry and an export-oriented industry. So what we are talking about are those countries that are highly developed, manufactured. And you know the difference between an industry and a manufactured industry. This is manufacturing. The trading is producing something, manufacturing something that you can sell. Okay? Some of you live in Moldova, Santa Cruz. Some of you come here not always walking, but by bus. That is an industry. It also could be a transport service. So, industries could be services or goods. Manufacturing this is manufacturing. So, the use, the bottle of it, the bottles, things like that, we do manufacturing. Okay? Then we can start. Last week, we ended the lecture half past four. I don't think we can manage to do that. Any questions since we've ended before having talked? Not yet. What we're talking about is the political economy in effect. So it is policy influence politics. So far, we see the difference. The politicians influence change with the political attack. If you look at GDP, not GPS, but GDP, what is GDP? So that is what you produce every year in the country. Gross domestic product. It would be produced within an economy over 1 year. Who do you think have the highest GDP for the US compared to Bangladesh? Why do we have a higher GDP compared to Bangladesh? Can have another reason for it, and a lot of explanations. Can you think of one? Examples of cars. Now we can change to a different one. Aircraft. Any of you been planning to buy yourself a helicopter or an aircraft in the near future? No. had done the media money. So this whole hierarchy they produce with more advanced technology. So there are fewer that can produce the same, so they also produce as a manufacturer goods that more are willing to pay for and can buy for the price to come. So therefore, do the same. In addition, number one, you have to cut. Okay? Why will Mexico have a lower GDP in per capita profit than the US? Then we go back to the beginning of this course, the first lecture. It's about 2 months ago, isn't it? You have a wave idea. What is the difference between a large company in one side and a large country in the other side? It was your task to educate President Clinton to tell you what is the difference between a large firm and a large company is a firm in some order to be their success. What about countries? I think the countries realize that they are not many French pieces in Moldova. So you have to eat the pieces. Most of what is consumed in the country is yes. Then what counts is simply the income. And what is the income level if you compare US to Bangladesh? That's all of you do not get. So, what we produce in the US, there will be consumers able to pay a higher price than they do to sell in Bangladesh. Okay? But do you think Americans would go to Bangladesh to buy their laptops, their cell phones, their pizza, or their clothes? So, those living in the US consume more for the same goods than to be in Bangladesh. So, therefore, the GDP will be higher simply because they have more money to spend. And you can ask, there are more people with more money in the US than there is in Bangladesh. Okay. Next to Bangladesh, there is the country that looks like this. India. And the more inhabitants in India compared to the US. Is the income level in India higher than the US? No. So there is something, let's say, with the history of the country that also has given differences, let's say, in income level. I'll try to explain that with this example in Norway. You know where it is. You know, you have been. Okay. It came exactly 200 years too late to experience our constitution. Because in the 17th and 18th constitution, it came 109 years too late to experience when we became independent. That was in 1902. So Norway was a developing country. Don't worry, it is less than 100 years ago. So, can we use Norway as an example to explain the difference in GDP? No addition? Yes? What happened in 1776? France did France, because France were fighting alongside the British forces to get independence. Right. But then, they are not very nice. country, what happened in 1978? From America. So they were colonies. They had to be sort of pity to be late. Simply because they were not in the country. So part of this is to say, when did you become independent? How many years extra do you get after independence if you live in the US compared to India? 172 years. Can you imagine what has happened to France in 172 years from now? And we talk about 2186. Probably a lot of that. So part of this is explained by how long we have developed. So far, so good. So nice to be. Most of the development in India came in the 1990s. Okay? How many years after? 42. Most of the development in the US did not come in 42 years, which is 1, 2, 3. Most of the development in the US came much later. So, in fact, India has had a faster development than the US. And that is why it is important for their sales, because we got their independence much earlier. We got a Portuguese colony. Colony. Okay. A long time ago. Part of the differences in the economy of the country is the coming of the Indian capital. Do you know what the neighbor of India has called? Okay? It's North, Nepal, and when did they get their independence? 1939. Most of the development of China and China's economy has been after 1990. And if you wake up one morning and somebody whispered in your ear, Deng Xiaoping, who was Deng Xiaoping? Part of the development in countries has been economic development. Okay? The biggest economy in the world is the creation of currency to do things. This is the key. This is for democracy, this is for the people. So these two things have developed, or have developed in two different ways. Both of us have developed. I don't think the political system needs to be in the world. can discuss it in some more detail. Why should they choose import substitution as a trade option? It's simply that they did in the US, that they did in what now is developing countries in the 1920s and the 60s. Because we have to. Okay? Why is it not necessary to success today? The next one thing. Infant industry simply means one to get manufactured industry. Why do you need to do that? And can you try to export this service? Very difficult to do. So most of what you export is like services that use our money to introduce manufacturing labor because we want to sell goods. Easier to transport, easier to drop off, easier to cool down, or just transport in the pressure, then you can pass it. Or with no pressure, then you can oil, and we know how to export. But it's no problem to know what oil is because you can stick your finger into it. And it's sticky things. You can try to do the same in natural gas, then I will do it black. For one very sticky thing, and then it's. And it's very thick. It's kept in the cluster, and that is taking it down. What would happen if it hadn't been cooled down? You never heard. When you have slaves in the city state, and you call it in Norway by the Eastern, by the Wanda. This is telling you anything, but that's how I make the city. They were transporting gas. Oh no, generating gas. No, outside South Africa, and outside the Philippines, turning shuttles. So it is possible to touch. Don't pass that gas and gas instead of the water. That is why we use electricity in Norway for these gas hydrogen, like a car. So you don't burn your finger. You can do it like that. Yeah? So it has to be manufactured. Until 1980, when it shipped, this was. Running trade policy. Support and protect your manufacturing industry to build them up so that they start the export and then you can earn money to pay for the import. We call the 1980s for the Asian white milk. Why Asian? South Korea. Do you know what it is? Asia. Hong Kong was, it's not part of the United China. Singapore, we've been to Malaysia because that's a lake. Have you been to Taiwan? That's nearby. So this is Taiwan. All of these trading nations were in Asia. We used to call them PANC. Newly industrialized countries. They started the industry to develop the production at home to export it. In the financial crisis, October 2008, when the bank in the US went bankrupt, that is the financial crisis. also changed the condition for most of what explains whether we are developed or developing or system. Africa was independent. Most of the African states were independent in no one had been known as the condition. And late 50s and early 60s. I think the first independent state that was actually before was in 1956. The last was about 1964. The history explains why they are still developing. They had to take it to the second. Unlike Brazil, they had had more years, they are still developing. The history explains one thing. They let go back 250 years. 10 years was a developing country. The USA developed from 1776 in a 150 year period before they became independent. So no country has been what we call developed for a very long period. And then we say, well, what about Greece? Or what about China a long time ago? What if you exported goods that they do both in China a long time ago, or in Greece, not too long time ago, or in Italy, or again, a long time ago? Most of the development happens after 1900. Two starts before, they are in colonies and they call them UK. And none of you learn about this in nature. If you are young, you have to know that because of good and poor means of my parents, they are not so much to do. So part of the development starts in the middle of 1800. Most of the development of the rest of the world starts in the 1950s and 60s. We like to think that we are the developer. How many are there? How many European states are there? 20%, 15% of all the oldest states are European. The rest of them are the United States. So that must be a concept if you are from the state. You are among the majority. Start getting independent. Then they can decide what they need. Policy. Some nations split up. And none of you know who are the last nation to split up. Sudan. Nation stop. Split up. What is the latest split up in Europe? They merged together. The latest paper, I think, is Czechia and Slovakia. Okay, so they are later. So these are the Eastern European states, they still have in Europe. So no wonder they are developed in Eastern Europe, because the nations are the same. Some of the colonies, as we said, the U.S. was a colony. The Central Republic of Africa has been a colony under Queen's regime. But so many of the colonies were owned by France, or owned by France, were related to and we will have a discussion with the Swedish author, because it would have been better for the world if Germany won the first world instead of the first one. But that will be during the day. And it's not allowed to throw stones during the debate. Okay. These are nations where the health, there's healing, and worship. The third was the colony, the worst was the colony, Russia was the number of colony, and it has split up. And if you don't know it, look at the news tonight, and you hear about Ukraine, which once was the part of the big empire called the Soviet Union. And it has split up. So all of them split up. Norway. There's no reason there. Who did we split up? We split twice. Denmark, Sweden, independent 1905. That's in 110 years ago. So you have had 110 years to do that. It's going to be a problem to catch up with China. It's going to stay silent. What is it? Spain, you still have colonies. Portugal, you still have colonies. Are they developed? Among the top when it comes to GDP, you can buy Spanish, like you can do GDP. But most of the nations have either been colonies or independent states. If that does not explain how it developed, in fact, somebody says that Spain would have been better without the colonies of South America. Because what did Spain bring back from South America? Gold, gold, gold. What do you get if you have another one? And also, the power. And since you cannot produce for truth of temptation, you are in trouble. So, probably one thing, dear, when you got money, see that you are trying to buy at the same time. So, let's start with Nova. 200 years ago, for a constitution, one of the first rebellion organizations, organizing labor, just what was their priority? Cut taxes. Why on earth would labor organizations ask the government to cut taxes? They didn't know clean and you did, so come up against the people. Why did the labor in Norway ask for cutting taxes when they wanted to pay the electric to put them to the yes. They saw what Truman saw. So, but for all I know, he has a relative in Norway that emigrated from Norway to the US. Because the one that organized this organization in Norway, he went to the US and ended his life in the US as a labor organization in the US. But he forgot something. And that was but also clothing cuts. So he died to it. We think in Norway that maybe the most important part of the development runs back to family time. What does family time mean? It's hard to do to know because we are economists in Norway. But it simply means every family had fewer members. There were fewer to feed. There were more money to be spent on food. But probably that is the most important part. Reduce the number of birth of kids because you have extra birth because you think they're dead. So you get too many kids and hope some of them will survive. So when you are at my age, the kids. That changed in the 1920s and on. He started to change the size of the family. And probably that is the most important development element in this. Don't have too many members of the household. And since you cannot get more grandfathers and more grandmothers, he started to change. So make the life of the kids safer. See that they survive the first 5 years. And that is me. So if you want to write now, start with the sun. So now we have developed, the country can start to produce. What should we produce in the world? Or what did we produce? An export to Brazil. Programming projects. What is in there that we exported from this country? That was vulnerable to profit for the new experiment in the world. Did we produce this enough? And people said, yes, we haven't done that. But that's not it. So most of what we export, in fact, the two most important export points in Norway is not producing. Because it is this and oil and gas. And since we have seen a break, why can we not produce oil and gas? It's a 15-minute question. We have 15 minutes to come up with an answer. But why don't we produce oil and gas? Are in Norway, are in Saudi Arabia, are in Brazil, are in the Chinese world? Why do we not produce? And we have one hit. Time. 50 minutes is 15:30. Have a nice break. Hallelujah. And remind you of the ticket. I hope you see my PC is.